Blackstone Audio presents Hot Start, a Cordell Logan mystery by David Freed. This book is read by Ray Porter. In Fond Memory of Aurelia Valley. Man is the cruelest animal. Friedrich Nietzsche. Who murdered Roy Hollister wasn't the question. The question was, who didn't want to murder him? Most residents of swanky, seaside Rancho Bonita were not surprised when somebody finally did. The surprise was that his third wife, Tony, was killed alongside him. Many may have spurned Hollister for the way in which he made his fortune, but all agreed that Tony, gracious and philanthropic to a fault, didn't deserve to be butchered too. An innocent bystander, foolish enough to have married a veritable monster. The high temperature in Rancho Bonita soared that afternoon to a record-breaking 101 degrees. The couple were enjoying a cooling late-night dip in the pool behind their 8,000-square-foot French colonial mansion when they were shot. The pool was shaped like the continent of Africa. The mansion was nestled on 5 lushly landscaped acres overlooking the central coast of California. A $25 million slice of heaven that Hollister could have never envisioned owning one day when he dropped out of high school and took a minimum wage job sweeping floors at a gun shop in Fresno. The same store where he would later chance upon an article in Guns and Ammo detailing the rising popularity of big game hunting expeditions. Borrow 10 grand from his sister and begin chartering safaris to the Tanzanian bush. The irony that Hollister and his wife had been killed by large-caliber rifle bullets, the type used to fell elephants and Cape buffaloes, was not lost on the police, nor among the couple's mostly left-leaning, animal-loving neighbors.
I don't wish bad on anybody, but let's just say that what goes around comes around,
one neighbor, money manager Jackson Giamatti, told a Rancho Bonita television reporter 2 days after the shooting.
May he rot in hell for what he did to all those poor defenseless creatures.
Not that Giamatti or anyone else interviewed by the local media claimed to have actually ever talked to Hollister, the king of the Big Five, as he touted himself on his website. All they knew of the man was what they'd read online about him or heard third hand via the grapevine, that he was an arrogant jerk who charged well-heeled outdoorsmen upward of $50,000 apiece to shoot rare and exotic species in Kenya, Namibia, and other faraway hunting preserves. A few local residents said Hollister seemed pleasant enough, on the surface anyway. He'd even wave at them occasionally, rumbling past in his black Hummer with its Eat Lion vanity plate. The consensus, however, was that he mostly kept to himself. A preternaturally tan 65-year-old with hair plugs and a spouse 20 years his junior. A gardener discovered their nude bodies shortly after sunrise. Roy Hollister was found floating face down in water tinged pink with blood. He'd been killed by what military snipers call a catastrophic brain shot. Investigators would retrieve pieces of his skull from the deep end, lodged in the pool's drain. Tony Hollister had died apparently while climbing the pool steps, her legs still submerged in the shallow end, her arms splayed over the terracotta decking. One bullet had creased her scalp, another had nicked her spine and exited her chest below her left armpit, leaving a hole the size of a Krugerrand gold piece. Several nearby residents reported being awakened by gunshots shortly after 1 a.m. Considering that the Hollisters' computer-monitored privacy gates appeared not to have been breached that night, investigators deduced that the fatal rounds had been fired from considerable range, 600 meters or more. The shooter, given that distance, was assumed to have been an experienced marksman, possibly military trained. With palm trees and a row of cypress pines blocking the pool from view on three sides, police also concluded that the shots could only have come from the sparsely inhabited hills to the north, looking down on the Hollister estate. From where, specifically, though, no one could say. Cloaked in chaparral and veined by dry, narrow arroyos, the area offered myriad secluded firing positions where the killer could have lain in wait, unseen in the darkness. Less than a month after the shootings, Hollister's older brother, Skip, the one who...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.